Advice to follow before your next software testing interview in the year 2021. Yes, you heard it right. This video is all about that. So without wasting time, let's get started. Without preparation, do not apply for the job. Apply only when you are prepared. You know that we are in a world of competition where competition is more, and also more because of Corona crisis. Lot of people are there to get a job. So apply job only when you are prepared. Don't apply job if you are not at all prepared, because you get only one chance to attend interview in one company for the next 6 months to 9 months to 12 months. I don't want you guys to get rejected. Prepare yourself best and then only apply for the job. HR will call you and they will tell you to attend the interview today itself, but it is your responsibility to ask them for a time. They will tell you to attend the interview today, they will force you to attend the interview today or tomorrow. But it is your responsibility to ask for the time. If you have already applied for the job but you are not yet prepared, ask for the time. You can ask for a period of 1 week, 5 days. If you have already applied for the job and you are not prepared still, what you can do is you can ask the HR for a time. Prepare yourself and then only attend the interview. Rejections does not make you weak but stronger, believe me. Every interview rejection is going to teach you something, and what is that something you need to focus on? Because when you are getting rejected, there will be reason for that. Try to understand that reason, work on it, prepare yourself best from what you were yesterday, and definitely you'll be able to catch a good job, believe me. Learn from your mistakes. Glance your resume 20 minutes before your every interview to make sure that you are capable of answering each and everything what your interviewer is asking, because there should not be a case where interviewer is asking you something from your resume but you ended up not answering it, or you ended up being confused in that. So to make sure that, glance your resume 20 minutes before every interview to make sure that whatever points you have written in your resume and you already know it. If you don't know something, remove that from your resume. If you don't know something, do not add that in your resume. Just because you want to get selected into that company, do not try to add that particular thing or that particular skills in your resume that you are not aware of totally, because that will not help you. Whatever things you are going to write in your resume, you should be capable of explaining at least those. Be confident when you answer something to avoid unnecessary kind of questions from the same topic. If you be confident, they will feel that you know it. If you show a little careless, and if you show your nervousness, definitely they are going to ask more questions from the same topic just to take out from your mouth that I don't know. So don't do that. Don't give your interviewer a chance to make you nervous by asking multiple questions from the same topic which you don't know. Always be confident when you answer anything. Even though you have not worked on that practically, just show him that you have worked on. Show your confident level, which will make him to move to the next question. Set your aim to give more number of interviews. Even though you are getting rejection, there is no problem in that. That is making you perfect, believe me. Set your aim that you have to give more number of interviews. In case you are not getting calls from your HRs, don't feel sad. Be happy. Feel happy for that. You are getting time to add multiple things in your resume. When you are not getting time, utilize that time in learning something new and add that particular skills to your resume. Keep updating your skills if you love your job and want to continue with the profession. Keep updating skills each and every day. Try to learn something new. If you're not learning something with each day of your work, office work, you are really missing something. With each day, you should be capable of adding an extra skill to your resume. Attend your interview with paper and pen. Try to note something that is worth writing in. As most of the interviews today are virtual and it is not one-to-one, try to note it down. Anything that you feel that it is worth writing. Maybe you don't know something while attending the interview, just note it down, practice it well, become stronger for the next interview. Ask your colleagues and also friends who are working in the software testing profession to review your resume. Ask them what change you can do in order to make your resume look better than what it was before. Not just with one person, but review your resume with multiple persons. Ask them to give some comments about your resume. Whatever they are giving comments, try to figure it out if it is really worth changing or not. If it is, try to change it. Don't practice the same thing that you already know. Try to practice something which you don't know. Check out your confidence. Look, check out the area that you are lagging behind. Work on your communication skills, soft skills, presentation skills. Believe me, each one of the points that I've said here plays an important role while getting selected in one of the most biggest companies in this world. Soft skills, presentation skills, and the most important for software testers is communication skills. Don't shy to ask your friends or colleagues to take a mock interview for the skill that you are looking for. If you are looking for a job for the manual testing, ask your colleagues or friends to take your mock interview. If you are looking for a job for the position of automation engineer, ask your friends to take your mock interview. Do not shy back. It's your life. It's your job. You want to prepare yourself best from the others. Mock will help you a lot. Ask your friends. Ask your colleagues to take your mock interview. Believe me, it's going to help you. Prepare 15 to 20 lines of project details for the company that you are working on and tell the same thing in each of the interview that you are working on. That will really save your time while expressing yourself in front of the interview. Prepare any 15 to 20 lines of your project details for the company that you are working on and tell the same 15 to 20 lines to each and every interviewer where you are applying job. Do not step back to ask for the references. If you know someone who is your neighbor, who is your friend, who was your college mate, who was your school friend, or with someone whom you have just met once, do not shy to ask for the references. Ask him or her for the references. Believe me, people who come from the references, their priority will be more than one who applied directly. Ask for the references, don't shy. At the end of the interview, ask your interviewer, what is your feedback on me, where I can improve myself. Believe me, this soft gesture of yours can give you a job. I was once getting rejected because I could not answer most of the questions that my interviewer asked. But because of my sweet gesture that I asked my interviewer, what is the feedback you want to give it to me, which are the areas that you want me to improve on. I was holding a paper with pen. I noted down all the things that he said it, that where and all area I'm lacking on, and he selected me for the next round. So it all happened because I showed him the suit gesture of asking him the feedback, like how I was and where I need to improve. For any kind of answers, do not answer with just one word or one or two lines. Remember that people who know more, people who have greatest knowledge, do not speak less. They speak more on the topic they have asked to. So always remember to speak more. 1 hour before any interview, relax yourself. Make your mind peace and comfortable. Last moment brush up won't work out in most of the times. So always remember to calm yourself at least 1 hour before any interview. Show your smile throughout the interview. Do not show your nervousness to the interviewer. Smile. Nobody wants to hire someone who is very serious, believe me. Be humble and energetic in the interview. Nobody wants to hire someone who is a lazy guy. Always remember to be energetic and humble in the interview. That will really save you. I am 101% sure that if you really follow these 21 points that I have said you while attending any software testing interview, you will get a new job. So I hope this video was useful. If yes, you know what you have to do, right? Comment, like, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you guys. See you in the next video. Which video I should make next? Put that down in the comment section. You can reach to me out on my mail ID, Quora account, Twitter account, Instagram account, Telegram account, anywhere you feel like. All the links are there in the link description. Please check it out.